Hey y'all, welcome back. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Stephanie. I just want to take a second here to thank all my wonderful subscribers. Y'all mean the world to me, and I want to thank y'all for all the love and support. If you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, I would love it if you click that button and stick around for a little while. I have a bunch of fun projects on the way. Today, I want to show you how I made 7 super cute lemon decor pieces for tiered trays. Before we dive into the projects, I want to let y'all know that this Wednesday at noon, I'm teaming up with my good friend Amanda over at 6 Kids and a Glue Gun for a fun Thrift It and Flip It summer collaboration. So be sure to check back on Wednesday to see what fun projects we come up with. For the first project, I will be using a wooden barrel from Hobby Lobby, 2 leafy floral picks from Hobby Lobby, floral foam from Dollar Tree, 1 pack of the 1.9 inch foam balls from Dollar Tree, apple barrel lemon acrylic paint, a wax brush, a paintbrush, and Krylon's dark vintage antiquing wax. I start by staining the entire barrel with the dark vintage antiquing wax. I also make sure to stain a little bit on the inside of the barrel so that you don't see the raw wood once the project's finished. I will be making the mini lemons out of the 1.9 inch foam balls from Dollar Tree. I begin by crushing the foam ball using a little bit of pressure to make it easier to shape like a lemon. Once I have the foam a little bit softer, I put the ball on a hard surface and roll it using a bit of pressure, occasionally stopping to pinch the ends into the points of the ends of the lemon. This part of the project does take a little bit of time, especially depending on how many lemons that you're making. I only made 4 for my tree, but you can make as many as you want. I definitely suggest picking up a couple extra packs of these foam balls because some of them did fall apart because I was using too much pressure. Don't rush this process and use too much pressure. Just take your time and slowly mold it into the shape of a lemon. This is what you should have after a few minutes of working with the foam balls. Now that all 4 lemons are made, I stick them onto a skewer and give them 2 full coats of the apple barrel acrylic paint in the color lemon. Be sure to let the paint dry between coats. I will say that this did not take as many coats as I expected. The styrofoam on these balls really does take the color very well. To assemble the mini tree, I place a piece of floral foam inside the barrel and cut 2 of the leafy picks into 3 separate branches, removing the largest set of leaves on the bottom of each branch. Next, using one of the thick trunk pieces from the pick, I use hot glue to reattach the branches in a way that makes it look like a tree and not a leaf pick. I did this by bending out the branches and hot gluing them all the way around the trunk. Once I'm happy with the look of the tree, I stick it in the floral foam inside the barrel. Once I have the tree in the barrel, I use the extra branches to fill in and make the tree appear fuller. Once I'm happy with the fullness of the tree, I take some of this green Spanish moss and use it to cover the floral foam around the tree. Next, it's time to put the lemons on the tree. I use hot glue to attach the lemons to the tree where I think they look the best. If you want more lemons for your tree, you can use additional packs of foam balls and make as many as you want. You may notice I have a branch and lemon in the very front, but I end up removing the branch and moving the lemon to a different area because I decided that's where I wanted to put a little sign. To make the sign for the tree, I used one of the words from the mint sign from Dollar Tree and some black acrylic paint. I removed the word we from the sign and removed the paper. This was fairly easy to do using my heat tool and sandpaper. If you don't want to mess with removing the paper, you can flip the sign over and use the back. After I had the paper removed and both sides sanded, I gave the entire sign two coats of black paint, making sure to get the back and all four sides. This piece was completely dry. I used a farm fresh lemon stencil I made on my Cricut and a white metallic paint pen from Dollar Tree. I used the paint pen to fill in the words on the stencil. I did this twice, letting it dry between coats. I love how this turned out. I wanted it to be a little bit messy and to look a little bit handwritten, and I think this just nailed it. put the finishing touches on this project, I used one of the wooden dowels from Dollar Tree, and using hot glue, I glued it to the back of the Farm Fresh Lemon sign. Then I cut the dowel down to the length that I wanted and stuck it in front of the tree. I'm absolutely in love with how this tree came out. I think it screams summer, and just wait until you see it with all the other little tear trade minis that we're going to make. For project number two, I used a small black watering can from Hobby Lobby and a greenery pot from Dollar Tree. This DIY couldn't get any easier. You just put the greenery into the watering can, fluff it up a bit, and clean up the burlap. I did use some green Spanish moss to cover up the green floral foam on the inside, and you'll see what I'm talking about here in a minute. I did also use some hot glue to glue the burlap down around the edge of the pot so that it would look a little bit cleaner. And that's it, and you have a super adorable addition to any tiered tray. Now moving right along to project number three. I used the rake and shovel pieces off this watering can hanging decor from Dollar Tree and some Rust-Oleum Metallic Oil Rub Bronze spray paint. I started by removing the rake and shovel from the decor piece and took them outside and painted both the front and back. I didn't even bother removing the paper, and the paint covered it beautifully. Once the pieces were dry, I took some twine from Crafter Square at Dollar Tree, and starting at the notch in the handles of the rake and shovel, I used a dot of hot glue to wrap the twine almost all the way to the end of the handle, using additional hot glue where I felt it needed it. Now that both handles were wrapped, I used a dot of hot glue to glue the pieces together in an X shape. Then, using more twine, I tied a simple shoestring bow to finish this project. How cute did these little guys turn out? I love them, and they were so quick and easy to make. For this next project, I'll be using one of these mini rolling pins from Hobby Lobby, a piece of this lemon fabric from Walmart, some Mod Podge, and a foam brush. This project is another super easy one, but it's so adorable once it's finished. I start by measuring out how long and wide I needed the fabric and cut it out. I had the fabric cut out, I used the Mod Podge and applied it to the entire body of the rolling pin. While the Mod Podge was still damp, I took the fabric and wrapped it around the body of the rolling pin, using more Mod Podge as needed so that it would adhere nicely to the wood. Once I had the fabric on the rolling pin, I went around the edges and trimmed up anywhere that the fabric was hanging over the edge. Once that was done, I went back and put another coat of Mod Podge on the outside to seal it. rolling pin was completely dry, I used the apple barrel paint and the color lemon to paint both ends of the rolling pin. I ended up doing 2 coats of paint. I think this rolling pin came out precious. I love it, and I'll definitely be making more for different seasons and holidays. For the fifth project, I'll be using 3 of these squares from this pack from Hobby Lobby, lemon fabric, green fabric, and yellow fabric, all from Walmart, my Mod Podge, a foam brush, and some twine from Crafter Square. I'm going to be making a stack of books, so I'm going to use a fabric to cover the wood squares. I cut out a square of fabric and Mod Podge it onto the wood square. I cut and fold the end so that the square is completely covered and it looks neat and clean. Once I have the fabric on the square, I put an even layer of Mod Podge on the outside to make sure that it's good and secure. I use each of the fabric colors on the square, so when I'm done, I have a lemon book, a green book, and a yellow book. Once I had all 3 books covered and they were good and dry, I used hot glue to glue the stack together. Then I took some of the twine and wrapped it around the books using hot glue to hold it in place. I wrapped the twine around the top and bottom of the book. To finish this project, I took a leaf that was left over from the lemon tree project and glued it to the top of the stack. I'm super happy with how this book stack came out. It was really easy and quick to put together, and I love the pop of color it gives to the tiered tray. For project number 6, I'm using a leftover St. Patrick's Day sign, apple barrel paint in the color lemon, and this lemonade sign I cut out on my Cricut. This was a free SVG file, so I'll have it linked in the description box below. I start by removing the paper from the front of the sign using a heat tool and a sanding block. This was really easy to remove, especially with the sanding block. Once the paper was removed and the front of the sign was smooth, I gave it about 4 good coats of the lemon paint, letting it dry between coats. After the paint was dry, I decided to use a more coarse paintbrush and dry brush the lemon paint over the green sides. After that was done, I still thought that the sign looked a little flat, so I took some apple barrel paint in the color spring green and used the same brush to dry brush the color around the sides and front of the sign. If I happen to get the green a little too heavy in places, I just used the yellow color on top to kind of blend it all together. Now to finish the project, once the paint was completely dry, I applied the vinyl and that was it. I'm loving this little sign. I think it is so fun and definitely says summertime. Now for the 7th and final project. I will be using the salt or pepper shaker from Dollar Tree, Waverly chalk paint in the color maize, and a green straw from my drink bar. Since you can't really have a lemonade themed tiered tray without lemonade, I'm going to remove the top of the shaker and pour some of the chalk paint into the glass. I then gently move the glass around so that the paint coats the inside of the glass completely, adding more paint as needed. Once my glass of lemonade was completely dry, I measured out the length I wanted the straw to be and cut it to size. I then hot glued it into place. Okay, y'all, I think this little glass of lemonade is my absolute favorite out of all 7 projects. It's just so stinking cute and looks so refreshing. Leave me a comment down below telling me which project was your favorite. Time for the big reveal. Here is what all the projects look like arranged on my tiered tray. I'm obsessed with the way all these turned out, and I hope you enjoyed these projects as much as I did making them. And if you did, give this video a thumbs up, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button and become part of the Crafty Club. Also, be sure to check back at noon on Wednesday for the Summer Thrift It and Flip It collaboration video. I'll see y'all then.